and we're thermally removing the leaf layer with effectively a lightsaber. Okay, so my name is Julian Swan. I'm the CEO of PlasmaTrack. PlasmaTrack was incorporated in March 2020. The idea came out of a program that was funded by the Railway Safety and Standards Board called Predictable and Optimized Braking. We worked on that for 4 years. PlasmaTrack took the technology that was developed by the Imagination Factory within the RSSB funded Predictable and Optimized Braking program. What we've been doing over the last 18 months is developing more of a product. And we're going through trial product acceptance with Network Rail this autumn. And we believe that we will be product ready this time in autumn 2022. So it's a very, very fast process that we can do. So the problem that we were trying to solve is ubiquitously known as leaves on the line. So it was anything to do with predictable and optimized braking or adhesion on the railhead. And the idea that we had was to use plasma to target this slippy leaf layer. So the problem is that leaves fall and they get compressed onto the track with the trains rolling over them, and it creates a very hard, very slippy Teflon-like coating. And we are using plasma to thermally remove that layer and return the railhead to summer braking conditions. So this is the core to our technology. This is a direct current thermal plasma head. And what you see here is it's a very robust lump of metal. We have high voltage and gas, which are supplied, and that's what's creating the plasma. And as well as that, we have a cooling system. So this is, you know, cooling in, cooling out, high voltage in, high voltage out, and gas in. And then this copper nozzle is the exit point for the plasma, and that is approximately 25 millimeters from the railhead. And we're thermally removing the leaf layer with effectively a lightsaber. So the current embodiment is a cleaning system, and it is mounted onto a dedicated multi-purpose vehicle. So for 10 weeks of the autumn, our equipment is mounted onto this vehicle and they go out and they clean all around the UK. In the future, we hope to miniaturize the system and have it designed and suitable for every vehicle so that the trains can be completely independent of the weather conditions. And the final end for that is that the trains can drive as if it's summer all year round. We faced lots of challenges during this development. Working in the railway environment is a very aggressive environment. You need to develop something that's robust. So it's very important to use your structural analysis and consider vibration. Also, with COVID, working remotely was a challenge as well, and being able to work with our PDM system and check in, check out, keep control of the designs and understand where each of the team is within the development is also very important and very helpful with the SolidWorks platform. It's very important to do a lot of iterations within the virtual world before you start manufacturing parts, because that's when cost starts coming in. So we do a lot of work within the SolidWorks CAD package to iterate, to look into and investigate different concepts before we then think this is worthwhile to actually manufacture and then test. What gives us a cutting edge over those and other technologies that are maybe a bit more established is that our system is very robust, and it's been designed specifically for the railway environment. The railways is an environmentally focused industry. Network Rail are looking to reduce their carbon. The system that they're using currently for cleaning the track uses a lot of water and has an impact on the environment. The system we've designed has no consumable aspect to it. It uses less fuel and is more efficient. And SolidWorks has helped us in making sure that we're using the materials efficiently and designing things that are lightweight and robust and suitable for the railway environment. So for us, SolidWorks is a professional CAD package. It's the default for our industry. And being able to have access to that as a startup for zero for the first year of our business is like gold dust. So we're working very closely with Network Rail. We rely on their engineers to give us guidance with regards to regulations and standards. And what we do within SolidWorks is actually model those and bring in. So in one instance, we had to create a gauge which our equipment has to go through, which means that it's suitable for use around all of the network, all of the infrastructure. So we can simulate the train going through these gauges to make sure that it's appropriate for use. We find Solid Solutions very supportive and reactive as well, and that's key for us, is that we don't want downtime with our CAD, and within that we know we will get good training as well. So it's basically on the end of the phone or online, we get good support from Solid Solutions. So with Solid Solutions, when we didn't have capability in-house, we were actually able to use them as a resource. And specifically on some of our thermal and CFD capability, they were able to help us with designing the nozzle and the flow paths. And that was something we weren't able to do ourselves.